Here we go. Rehearsal, tuck in, clear back. Here
listen, hold on. We're not going to compromise our visual style because of a monsoon. We're going to get the shot. We're going to get the shot. Mauro,
Mitch. Somebody say action.
Action. Can't lose sight of the fact we have to make a movie that is emotionally involving, that has characters that are deeply involving. Because at the end of the day, all of your little camera techniques and all of these explosions, and Mal over there doing God knows watering a bunch of dirt, it doesn't matter. You understand? It's about human beings. You understand what I'm saying? It's about human involvement and pathos and human psychology. So what I'm going to try and do is we're going to create a scene of movement where human beings are moving through the scene. So what I'm thinking is Garner's moving, and she's going to see the blood all over that vehicle there where a human life is lost.
That one?
And she's going to be talking, and Fleury's going to kind of be moving. And I want all this carnage all around them. They're surrounded by carnage. You understand? Utter carnage. I want to feel the hatred of the act. And Cooper is going to be maneuvering, and Cooper's going to find this detonator, and he's going to pick it up, and we're going to have to see that detonator. And then he's going to move by Fleury, and he's going to hand the fucking thing to Fleury.
Holy shit.
Okay, easy. Can I just take him aside for a second?
I drank a fucking Red Bull. I've never had one.
The original idea for the film came when I read something about an attack that had occurred at a place called the Khobar Towers, which were a Western housing facility in Saudi Arabia. And I remember reading about the FBI trying to get a team on site in Saudi Arabia to investigate and having a lot of trouble.
Colonel Ghazi, Special Agent Ronald Fleury, Special Agent Mays, Special Agent Sykes, Special Agent Levy.
And I started thinking that it would be fascinating to watch these agents try and do their jobs. Basically then, Michael Mann's office is right down the hall from mine. I walked in his office one day and I said,
wouldn't it be great to do some kind of a homicide procedural investigation, except you're doing it in the most hostile of circumstances. You're doing it in Saudi Arabia, you're doing it in Riyadh, and they don't want you there.
And he kind of looked away for a second and said, yeah.
And the three of us got in a room and came up with this idea of let's see kind of the anatomy of this investigation following a crime that literally has happened in Saudi Arabia. And in May 2003, three Western housing complexes in Saudi Arabia were attacked in the same night. From that kind of seed and from those pictures, that kind of informed the script.
Action.
Number so far, 100 dead, 200 injured. Target was a softball game. Rumor is
killers wore Saudi police uniforms. Special Agent Fran Manning was killed.
After reading it, you feel for the characters. You feel for the fact that this agent, Fleury, who loses his best friend in one of the bombings. And the thing is that when you watch CNN and you watch how many people have lost their lives, you feel for it, but you really don't get a chance to really understand it until it happens to you. So that's what's interesting about it right there, is the fact that death has been brought to his doorstep, and now how does he deal with it?
Grant, take a stab at the bomb side.
From the craters, looks like they used a high explosive, possibly military grade.
When you're dealing with something that's current events, you know, and when you're dealing with institutions like the FBI that people know, and the government of Saudi Arabia and the people of Saudi Arabia, your obligation is to be as authentic as you possibly can. Michael, Pete, and I all agreed early on that let's just make sure everything looks, sounds, and feels as though it could really be occurring.
This whole is the case.
Your men are contaminating this. Do you understand evidence? And little things that are clues.
Unfortunately, in America, I think we know so little beyond our own shores. And if I can find a project that's a little informative and as immediate as this piece is, that's a piece I like to spend my energies doing.
Pete Berg came over to my house. He basically said, oh, you have to do this movie with me. It's going to be a blast. It's going to be really cool. And the script was so compelling, and I liked the role, and especially getting the chance to work with Pete, Jamie, and with Chris Cooper, and even Mr. Bateman.
Well, we do this kind of stuff all the time on Arrested Development, you know. Stuff's blowing up, flying around. So this is a little boring for me. What I'd like to do is a fire gag, somewhere where my hair catches on fire. That's really the only thing that gets me up in the morning. Oh!
Well, when I first read this script, it was big, action-packed, sort of scary in political intrigue and all that kind of stuff that, you know, these are not scripts that I'm asked to be a part of, so I was very eager to be a part of it and did some rain dances, and here I am. So I'm just trying to keep my head down and make sure people don't know I'm here, because if I'm seen here, they might. What is he doing in this movie?
I'm going out, looking a little for you. We look a little, a beat, one beat. Yeah.
I look at your eyes and I hear it. Okay.
Yeah.
The first. I was in my home, in Palestine, Israel. And someone called me to meet Pete, the director, and then I took the script and read it. I felt after that, yeah, I'm starting being involved and exciting for this script, because I felt the attitude was trying to bring harmony or to put focus on something important.
Did you come up with some funny stuff?
No, it's not.
It's
all funny. I'm calling our director, Pete Berg. Let's see if this works. I hope it does. I approached Pete at a Japanese restaurant about this role, and I think he felt sorry for me, and he gave in and cast me. I don't think there was anyone left. I think he had gone through his list, and he was at the, you know, his wit's end, and they had to start shooting. So.
Leave me a phone number because I might not have it.
Oh my God!
If that's not too much trouble. Leave
Yeah, it's too much trouble, Pia.
To page this person, press 5 now.
Oh my God! So embarrassing.
Brought to his doorstep, and then how does he deal with it?
Grant, take a stab at the bomb side.
From the craters. Looks like they used a high explosive, possibly military grade.
When you're dealing with something that's current events, you know, and when you're dealing with institutions like the FBI that people know, and the government of Saudi Arabia and the people of Saudi Arabia, your obligation is to be as authentic as you possibly can.
Michael, Pete, and I all agreed early on that let's just make sure everything looks, sounds, and feels as though it could really be occurring.
This whole is the case. Your men are contaminating this. Do you understand evidence and little things that are clues?
Unfortunately, in America, I think we know so little beyond our own shores. And if I can find a project that's a little informative and as immediate as this piece is, that's a piece I like to spend my energies doing.
Pete Berg came over to my house. He basically said, oh, you have to do this movie with me. It's going to be a blast. It's going to be really cool. And the script was so compelling, and I liked the role, and especially getting the chance to work with Pete, Jamie, and with Chris Cooper, and even Mr. Bateman.
Well, we do this kind of stuff all the time on Arrested Development, you know. Stuff's blowing up, flying around. So this is a little boring for me. What I'd like to do is a fire gag, somewhere where my hair catches on fire. That's really the only thing that gets me up in the morning. Oh!
Well, when I first read this script, it was big, action-packed, sort of scary in political intrigue and all that kind of stuff that, you know, these are not scripts that I'm asked to be a part of, so I was very eager to be a part of it and did some rain dances, and here I am. So I'm just trying to keep my head down and make sure people don't know I'm here, because if I'm seen here, they might. What is he doing in this movie?
I'm going out, looking a little for you. We look a little, a beat, one beat. Yeah.
I look at your eyes and I hear it. Okay.
Yeah.
The first. I was in my home, in Palestine, Israel. And someone called me to meet Pete, the director, and then I took the script and read it. I felt after that, yeah, I'm starting being involved and exciting for this script because I felt the attitude was trying to bring harmony or to put focus on something important.
Your commotion funny, sir?
No, it's not.
All funny.
I'm calling our director, Pete Berg. Let's see if this works. I hope it does. I approached Pete at a Japanese restaurant about this role, and I think he felt sorry for me.
Killers wore Saudi police uniforms. Special Agent Fran Manning was killed.
After reading it, you feel for the characters. You feel for the fact that this agent, Flurry, who loses his best friend in one of the bombings. And the thing is that when you watch CNN and you watch how many people have lost their lives, you feel for it, but you really don't get a chance to really understand it until it happens to you. So that's what's interesting about it right there, is the fact that death has been brought to his doorstep, and then how does he deal with it?
Grant, take a stab at the bomb side.
From the craters, looks like they used a high explosive, possibly military grade.
When you're dealing with something that's current events, you know, and when you're dealing with institutions like the FBI that people know, and the government of Saudi Arabia and the people of Saudi Arabia, your obligation is to be as authentic as you possibly can.
Michael, Pete, and I all agreed early on that let's just make sure everything looks, sounds, and feels as though it could really be occurring.
This whole is the case. Your men are contaminating this. Do you understand evidence and little things that are clues?
Unfortunately, in America, I think we know so little beyond our own shores. And if I can find a project that's a little informative and as immediate as this piece is, that's a piece I like to spend my energies doing.
Pete Berg came over to my house. He basically said, you have to do this movie with me. It's going to be a blast. It's going to be really cool. And the script was so compelling, and I liked the role, and especially getting the chance to work with Pete, Jamie, and with Chris Cooper, and even Mr. Bateman.
Well, we do this kind of stuff all the time on Arrested Development, you know. Stuff's blowing up, flying around. So this is a little boring for me. What I'd like to do is a fire gag, somewhere where my hair catches on fire. That's really the only thing that gets me up in the morning. Oh!
Well, when I first read this script, it was big, action-packed, sort of scary and political intrigue and all that kind of stuff that, you know, these are not scripts that I'm asked to be a part of, so I was very eager to be a part of it and did some rain dances and here I am. So I'm, you know, just trying to keep my head down and make sure people don't know I'm here, because if I'm seen here, they might. What is he doing in this movie?
I'm going out, looking a little for you. We look a little, a beat, one beat. Yeah.
I look at your eyes and then I hear it. Okay.
Yeah.
The first. I was in my home, in Palestine, Israel. And someone called me to meet Pete, the director, and then I took the script and read it. I felt after that, I'm starting being involved. And